I'm not sure if I can speak about it. It's hard. Yeah, it's okay. Let's do it. So, one day, to be specific, on March the 17th, I was having a good day, or what seemed was going to be a good day. Nothing special, I had my brekkie and I was going to take a shower to start my first home office day fresh and tidy.
Well, after all this COVID-19, Alfredo was the only one that needed to take public transport to arrive to the office, so I didn't want her to risk anybody else at the office.
I think my boss was upset with me. I'm not sure about the reason, but I was the only one asked to go home office. So I purchased some appliances online to make more comfortable my new workplace.
Estaba muy ansioso. Había días en los que entraba, salía, checaba el buzón a todas horas.
Just 1 second before taking the shower, someone rang the bell. And I grabbed my pajama shorts and went to see who was that. It turned out it was Auspice woman. So I opened the door and realized that she was struggling to open the building's door. So I decided to go and help. And while I was approaching her, I realized that my apartment's door was closing. That's when all the tragedy began. Anyway, my stuff was there and I went to sign the receipt. But for some reason, this woman ran away. I had no keys, no phone. I was new in the building. I was literally screwed. Fortunately, there was the cleaning guy and I borrowed his phone to call my wife.
Recibí una llamada y lo primero que escucho es, la cagué. Desgraciadamente, yo me encontraba trabajando y no podía ser capaz de ayudarlo ni pedir permiso. Y mucho menos iba a mandar un Uber para ayudarlo con sus estupideces.
My wife had all the intention to help, but she couldn't though. So I decided to try lock jumping the fence in the backyard. Hopefully the back door would be open. I tried to make it fast, so nobody sees me. So I surround the building, and just when I was about to make the push-up, this family start making weird questions. I was very ashamed. This was the most embarrassing moment for me in Australia. So I decided to try a different strategy and went to ring my neighbor's bell. He allowed me to jump through his backyard and I was back home. I'm very upset with Auspost, but more than upset, I'm disappointed because they never replied to my online complaints, to my phone calls, or follow any communication that I got with them. So they gave me no alternative rather than creating this initiative on change.org. I only need 30k signatures, and Auspost will pay back for all this traumatic experience. Rather than being upset, I should be grateful, because somehow all this experience gave me a purpose.